recent updates of Final Cut have introduced workflows to convert landscape, that's 16:9 videos, into vertical and square formats that are much better suited for social media platforms like Facebook and Instagram. In this fast and easy Final Cut video, I'll show you how Final Cut can automatically change the aspect ratio while retaining vision of the main action. We'll do all of this in Final Cut 10.5. And as a bonus, at the end of the video, I'll show you how to use the new social media specific titles and lower thirds that have recently been introduced in Final Cut. I'm Bruce Macbryde, and I can provide one-on-one personal tuition in Final Cut. That's over the internet with your screen shared so that I can direct you on your computer. Click the link in the description below. And if you haven't done so already, please like, subscribe, and press the bell. This is an easy process that will quickly convert the aspect ratio while still giving you the ability to tweak the results. First, I'll play this short 60-second promotional clip, which is in 16:9, and you'll then appreciate how different it looks in a vertical format suitable for Facebook. So let's look at the process. First of all, we will select the project in the browser and then duplicate the project as. We'll call that vertical and then go to video and select the vertical selection. And then you need to tick Smart Conform. This is where the magic happens. And then go to the highest resolution, that's if you want to, and say OK to that. You can see that it's actually analysing those timeline clips. Now let's play the vertical clip. And you can see how the text has been centered in there now quite nicely. And also the action is in the centre of the screen. And the thing to particularly watch is how the dragon here is maintained at the centre of the screen rather than moving from side to side. Let's go back to the first clip and we'll look at that, and the text there is nicely centered, but it would be nice just to move that down a little so we have the ability to adjust. And then if we move over to this clip, we can see that the text there has come in. Why don't we just lower that a little bit too, so it's out of the way of the action? And I'll play the rest of the clip through now. Finally, I'm going to have a look at this third clip in, and you can see that the dragons are a little bit too far out on the left-hand side. So if we can click that one now, I can move the background so we can see more of the dragon in the total clip. You can make further adjustments by using keyframes. Select the clip in the timeline, put the playhead at the beginning of the clip, and then in the inspector, click the Add Keyframe in the position line. Move the playhead to the center of the image where you want to retain the clip, and then select the Contents button at the top of the viewer, and move the image to the position that you want. Then press the Keyframe button again to fix the keyframe at that point. Then move to the end and reposition. Keyframes are automatically entered whenever you reposition the image in the viewer. So I'd say that that's a pretty smart conform to a vertical format. So now, as I promised, let's have a look at the titles and lower thirds that have recently been added. So we can add these into our vertical, and you can see how the titles confirm to the vertical format. And then this one here, just so that you can see it there. Now, it will let you do things like adding logos. And this will also comply with the square format. So here's a clip in the square format. If we drag in one of these lower thirds now, so you can now see that that's conformed to the square format, where the previous one in the vertical conformed to the vertical format. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. If you haven't done so already, please like, subscribe, and press the bell. There are new tutorials every Sunday.